Hi, and welcome to the Noctua YouTube channel. My name is Dan, and in this video we're going to be looking at our brand new NT-H2 thermal compound, and discussing how and when it can be used to enhance cooling performance. Further improving the award-winning NT-H1, our NT-H2 thermal compound uses a new fine-tuned mixture of metal oxide microparticles for an even lower thermal resistance and reduced bondline thickness at typical mounting pressures. This allows us to achieve an even better performance in most application scenarios, making it ideal for enthusiasts looking for that slight cooling edge. But what kind of differences in performance can you expect to achieve? As you can see, in our own standardized internal testing at various platforms and heat loads, lower temperatures of up to 2 degrees Celsius were attained when using the NT-H2 compared to when using our standard NT-H1. Of course, it's important to note that thermal paste performance can depend on many factors, such as application method and quality, bondline thickness, contact surface and quality, total mounting pressure and pressure distribution, heat load, or heatsink time. Therefore, comparison results may vary from setup to setup. When comparing to high-end paste such as the NT-H1 and NT-H2, where the differences can be small on some setups, it is also crucial to strictly control all parameters and tolerances to avoid misleading results. Therefore, in order to reduce the margin of error when comparing the two, it is crucial to do multiple applications and average the results. Despite all variations from setup to setup, there are three rules of thumb that hold true in many testing scenarios. Firstly, performance benefits show more clearly the higher the heat load is. For example, the performance benefit of the NT-H2 over the NT-H1 may not show on a 35-watt processor, like the AMD Athlon 200GE, but will usually show very clearly on a CPU like the AMD Ryzen 2700X, which can reach 125 watts with precision boost enabled. Secondly, performance differences will show more clearly on larger CPUs than on smaller ones. For example, they'd be more pronounced on AMD's TR4 than on the smaller Intel LGA 1151. In our internal tests, we only saw a 0.2 degrees C benefit on the LGA 1151 versus 2.1 degrees C on the TR4 setup. And finally, with current Intel CPUs, there can be up to 7 degrees difference in full load temperatures between individual CPU cores, especially on CPUs with a high number of cores. Often, these differences are due to internal tolerances of the processor, and therefore cannot be attributed to uneven thermal paste distribution or poor heatsink contact. To sum things up, results can generally vary from setup to setup, and whilst you may not see huge improvements when switching from NT-H1 to NT-H2 on low TDP CPUs or LGA 115X systems, with bigger CPUs or higher heat loads, there's a good chance you'll see an improvement of 1 to 2 degrees or more. We hope you found this video helpful, and for guides on how to optimally apply our NT-H2, please see the other videos linked below.